Hi, good evening. My name is Helen Palasek, I'm the director here at the library. I want to welcome you all to this summer concert. The Aeolian Winds is going to do a summer pops for us, and I'm just delighted that you're all here. Surprised about the empty seats because we had more people say they were coming, but I don't know if the weather outside is so nice, or if they decided to stay home or what. But in any case, we are going to enjoy it very much. I want to take the opportunity to let you know that this concert and all of our other special events this year are being funded through the generosity of the Friends of the Library. I'd like to introduce to you the Aeolian Winds of Pittsburgh. They were here last December for a Christmas concert, and we just thought they were the best, and we wanted them to come back. And Alex told us about this summer concert, so I hope that you enjoy it. I know you'll enjoy it. And Alex, would you introduce your quick members, please?
Thank you. Thank you so much, Helen, for having us back, and we're glad to be here. Let me introduce everybody that's playing, including their instruments. So on the flute, Peggy Greb. I'm Alex Jones, I'm playing the clarinet. Kyle Morlock playing horn. Steve Aaron playing bassoon. And Kaylin Shear playing oboe. Very glad that Kaylin is here with us. We're going to start, so this program is centered around film music. And so we're going to take a lot of film scores and we're going to reduce them down to the core of what's really important, play them on five instruments. We're going to start with not a traditionally composed for film piece, but a piece that has been used in a lot of film, the Suite for Peer Gynt. And so you'll recognize a lot of these tunes, the Morning Mood and the Mountain King at the end. So this is three of the four movements of the Peer Gynt Suite number one.
Thank you.
Characteristics of film music. It's written by a composer from New England, but also who spends a lot of time in Florida. It's called Sunshine State, and her name is Gwyneth Walker. She was actually here in Pittsburgh. We did a performance of some of her music with the Bella Voce Women's Chorus in East Liberty, and we're very fortunate to have her there to coach us a little bit on this piece, as well as some of her other music. And so we're very pleased to play for you Sunshine State. I'll tell you the movement titles now. The first movement is called Vitamin C. The second is called Steamy Stroll. The third is Mango Fandango. And there's a little percussion that you'll see in that. And the last one is Sun and Sand.
Thank you. Thank you.
film scores in re-released movies. Many of you may have seen that Jurassic Park has come around again for Jurassic World. Has anybody seen Jurassic World? A couple of people. So you'll recognize some of the tunes from this next medley. We're going to do a medley of John Williams' favorites, starting with Indiana Jones. We'll have a little bit of Jurassic Park, and then you might hear some E.T. as well.
Thank you.
so we're going to recover for a minute. So the next piece that we're going to play, I'm going to talk for a little bit.
It's tough to reduce John Williams down to 5 instruments.
They're all brass instruments, except for one. The next piece we're going to play is a complete arrangement of The Sorcerer's Apprentice. And this is the feature piece that Walt Disney centered his vision for Fantasia around. Around 1950, Walt Disney decided he wanted to go beyond the theme park kind of idea into the movie theater. And he wanted to take the piece of this Dukas piece, The Sorcerer's Apprentice, and he wanted to make it a feature for Mickey Mouse. It was really a way to revive the character of Mickey Mouse, which had kind of fallen down a little bit in terms of there were other competing characters around, and it had lost its notoriety, and so this was a way to bring him back in grand style. So he envisioned this movie. He actually envisioned it as something that would occur every 5 years. He was going to do Fantasia 1 and then Fantasia 2 and so on and so forth. Recently it was revived in 2000 with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra and James Levine performing a lot of music by just great stuff. I think the Firebird was on there and just some wonderful pieces, but this was the piece that really started it all. It was a wonderfully advanced kind of experiment for the time to take that kind of animation and to take a film score, or to take a classical work and to turn it into a film score like that was just a grand vision. And so we're very fortunate to have that part of the movie literature. So, if we have enough time, we're going to perform a complete arrangement of The Sorcerer's Apprentice.
Thank you. Thank you.
so much. We'd like to conclude today with another movie that is going to be featuring a revival. This winter, Star Wars Episode 7 will visit your movie theaters. And so we'd like to conclude with a medley from Star Wars.
Thank you. Thank you.